love God. So on today, oh God, God, we honor you, Lord God, for being the great I am.
Yes,
oh
God.
God, you are everything that we need you to be, oh God. God, so we will now come against fear, and I lose boldness in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody give God some praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory, 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 glory. First of all, I want to give honor to God for allowing me this chance and for using me and for calling me, because there's plenty of people, but we know as many are called, but few are what? Few are chosen. And I thank God for being amongst the chosen ones, and I thank him for using me on today to speak to his people. I want to give honor to whom honor is due, give honor to my very own bishop and overseer. Come on, let's give God praise for them, for allowing their people to minister. We know there are plenty shepherds out there that hold their sheep back and don't give them a chance and an opportunity to minister. But we got the best bishop and overseer that Columbus, Georgia, the world has. We have the best bishop. Come on, let's give them some honor on today. So we can go in the bathroom and we can bring one of our friends in. We can just prophesy them up and down in the bathroom. That's how we do it, right? Huh? Is that how we do it? No, that's not how we do it. We can pull somebody to the side and say, I got a word for you. And I hear God say, blah, 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 blah. Is that how we do it? No, that's not how we do it. How are we supposed to do it? In decency and in order, right? In order. Okay, and also we know where to prophesy. We know how to prophesy, when to prophesy. Bishop has been going over that. It's just like Bishop has been this pitcher of water. What I've been seeing is this pitcher of water, and Bishop has just been pouring it all into us. She's been showing us and teaching us things that we can do in the prophetic realm and how to do those things in the prophetic realm. But you know what? We're just yet scratching the surface.
Come on now.
We're just yet scratching the surface.
Come on now.
It's time for us to go deeper and us to go higher in the prophetic realm. And for us to go deeper and higher in the prophetic realm, we got to be prayed up.
Come on now.
We got to be fasted up. And we got to make sure we spend that time with God to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. So that's how we're going to go deeper in the prophetic. And we're going to go deeper in the prophetic, not just by prophesying, because we know that's the least that we can do is prophesy, right?
Right.
But God wants to use us through our dancing, through our singing, through our playing, through
He
wants to use us prophetically. So we're going to go into this. Say it's time for a shift. Come on, say it like you mean it. It's time for a shift. Come on, proclaim it into the atmosphere. It's time for a shift. Say it one more time. It's time for a shift. So we declare and we agree even now in the name of Jesus that Kingdom Faith Outreach is doing what? It is shifting. It is shifting right now. So I'm going to talk about three things really quick. The gift of prophecy. We know that the gift of prophecy is to proclaim or to speak forth the purpose of God, right? So the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 14 and 1, it tells us to eagerly desire the gift of the Spirit, especially what? Prophecy. Especially what? Prophecy. Bishop has been saying that Wednesday after Wednesday. He wants us to eagerly desire to prophesy. In 1 Corinthians 14 and 2, it says, but the one who prophesies speak to people for the what? The strengthening, for the encouraging, and for the comfort. So we know that prophecy is what?
Encouraging and comfort.
Prophecy is what? Come on.
Encouraging
and comfort. And so we know that only the bishop can prophesy. Only the bishop can prophesy. Only the overseer can prophesy. No. Who can prophesy?
Everybody
from Cheyenne on to Mother Doja can prophesy. Because God can use the baby too.
That's right.
So everybody can prophesy. Okay? And so then you have the office of a prophet. This is a person that God uses to communicate with men. A person that is committed to speaking God's truth to others. That is a prophet. But we know that not only prophets can prophesy, but everybody can prophesy, right?
Come on now.
But there is an office of a prophet that you don't want to step in unless you know that God has called you into that realm, right?
That's right.
Okay, let's see. In Deuteronomy, okay, please, if I get that word wrong, y'all know what I mean. Deuteronomy 18 and 18, it says, I will raise up from them a prophet like you from among the brothers. And I will put my word in his mouth. And he shall speak. He shall speak to them all that I command him. Those are the prophets that he is raising up in this season, in this hour, to rebuke, to correct, to comfort, to encourage. Because y'all know that prophecy ain't all about houses and cars and land. It's not that. But sometimes God gives us a warning, and he sends a warning through who? Through the prophet.
Come on now.
Sometimes he still wanted to say, Ryan, you know what? You just being very disobedient, and you know that you need to be obedient. And so instead of us saying, I don't like that, but she ain't prophesying like she prophesied to Deke over here, oh, you're going to get a new car, you're going to get a house.
Uh-huh.
Both of them is from the prophet.
Right. We want to stay the life.
Come on. We want to be, we prophecy. So we talked about the gift of prophecy. We talked about the prophet. Now we're going to talk about the gift of the prophetic. Okay? This requires the grace of God. The Bible tells us in Romans 12 and 6 that we have all different gifts according to the grace given each of us. So I want to make sure y'all hear that. Romans 12 and 6, so y'all can write this down so y'all can go back in. Because any time that somebody is up here preaching, you don't want to just go off of what they're saying.
That's
you
right.
want to make sure that it's in the Word of God.
All right, now.
So in Romans 12 and 6, it says that we have different gifts according to the grace that is given to us.
Right.
If you have the gift of prophecy, then prophesy in accordance to your faith. If it is serving, then serve.
Yes,
is it teaching? Then teach. If it's to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is to give, then give graciously. If it is to lead, then lead diligently. If it is to show mercy, then do it cheerfully.
Come
whatever
on.
Gift God has given you,
come on.
Do it.
Come on.
Do it. Just be like the people when the people was at the party and it was time for Jesus. Jesus was going to turn the water into wine. And Mary told them, whatever he tell you to do,
do it.
Do it.
So
whatever gift that you have, no matter if it's playing the keyboard, if it's greeting the people, whatever gift,
come
you
on.
Do it to the best of your ability. Because you're not serving me and you're
That's
serving
right.
whom? You're doing it as you're doing it unto the Lord.
That's right.
So whatever
right.
gift that you have is no gift that's too small and it's no
yeah.
gift that's too big to God. So whatever gift you have, just I want you to look at your neighbor and tell them this. Learn how to flow.
Learn how to flow.
So, the word flow means to move along,
right.
to go out speedily, and continue in a current or stream, to move in one direction. When you think about flowing, just think about when you're going in the traffic. When you go in traffic, you go with the what? With
flow.
The flow of the traffic,
yeah.
right? If this traffic is going this way, you're not over here going the opposite way, right?
On,
you're going with the flow. So that's what God is telling us today. Learn how to go
on,
with
now.
The flow.
That's good.
With the flow. We're in a prophetic season right now. Oh, my God. I'm so excited. I don't know if y'all see what I see, but we in a prophetic realm. We are under an open heaven. Oh, my God. We are in a season where signs, wonders, and miracles are about to be performed. We're in a season that we can speak to a thing. We can speak these into existence. We can speak that thing. You know, you're probably going through in your marriage. Oh, my God. You're probably having trouble. But you know you can speak that thing. You can speak that thing into existence. Whom God put together, let no man put asunder.
Come on now,
you can speak that thing.
Speak
that two are better than one. That's what it said in the word. It said that two are better than one. Come on now. We're in this season where we can speak forth some things. And I looked up some synonyms for the word flow. It says run, it says move, go along, proceed,
yeah.
drift.
Yeah.
To gush, to whirl, to squirt, to ooze, to drip, to leak, to ripple, to overpour, to outpour, to rush, to tide and stream.
My God.
And what I saw was, oh my God, let me tell y'all, I have been up. I've been up and God has just been showing me some stuff. And what I saw, Courtney, I saw a woman giving birth. And you know when a woman gives birth, now sometimes some people want to just break out a mat, you know, and that water just flow. But sometimes the doctor got to come in and he got to break the water for us. So this is what's happening today. God is coming in this place. And he's getting ready to break some waters in this place so we can give birth to what God has called us to do. As the scripture says, it says, out of the belly, out of the belly shall flow rivers of place and help. We're going to start with the woman of God. We're going to start with the head first. Help her to give birth to the things that God has called her to do. Because y'all do know that Bishop Veronica, no, let me take that back. Apostle Veronica Word Hayes is not confined to these four walls. Y'all do know that, right? Y'all do know that Apostle Veronica Word Hayes is called to the nation. Y'all do know that, right? So we are going to become midwives to her to help her to give birth to everything that God has in store for her.
Okay,
the L stands for faith. We know that without faith it is worthless. believe that, you can have faith in him that he will do nothing, nothing. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Okay. Ooh, and the L stands for listen. Come on now. God wants us to listen to him. Listen means to give one's attention to a sound. When I heard it, it says give one's attention to a sound. So there is a sound that God wants to achieve in this realm on today. And God said that he wants you to give an ear to the sound.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. Simple stuff. to walk in the gifts
Don't want to have a baby side of us, my Lord. Surely, I think it's the one earth. Out the galaxy. We don't want that little bitty stuff. Amen. Amen. So when we praise our God, when we worship our God, we want to praise him for what he's going to do. The big thing that we're expecting, that we're believing, that we're seeing. Hallelujah. 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 So according to your faith, be it unto you. According to your faith, not my faith, can't go off mine. It has to go off of your faith. Amen. 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 So come on, everybody, let's close it out with a praise. Come on. Come on, everybody.
So what I-